Dangerous Drugs Board Chief Janicio Santiago submits a very brief resignation letter to the Office of the President after having a talk with Executive Secretary Salvador Mechaldea Monday. According to sources, Duterte was displeased by Santiago's statements about how the administration is handling the illegal drug problem. Santiago earlier said the Nueva Ecija Mega Drug Rehabilitation Center funded by Chinese tycoon Huang Rulun was a mistake. He said the rehabilitation center expected to house 10,000 patients is ineffective since it crowds suspects together while cutting their ties from support systems like their families. Santiago also said the rehabilitation center was impractical. He said, quote, "That was a mistake. The problem is the president got excited, but the money could have been spent on small community-based rehabilitation programs that can accommodate only between 150 to 200 people. Santiago is the second DDB official to be fired for remarks about the Duterte administration's war on drugs policy. The person Santiago replaced, former DDB chief Benjamin Reyes, was also sacked by Duterte for giving the wrong number of drug users in the country. Duterte then said, quote, "You do not contradict your own government." Santiago, a former Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency chief, is the official often quoted by Duterte as one of his sources for his claim that there are 4 million drug addicts in the country. This figure is critical in bolstering Duterte's narrative that this bloody war on drugs is necessary. Duterte supported the senatorial bid of Santiago in 2016, a bid which Santiago lost. Presidential spokesman Harry Roque on Tuesday says he defends the rights of both journalists and rabid online defenders of President Rodrigo Duterte. This after some Duterte online defenders slammed him and called for his resignation for allegedly going soft on journalists when he defended their right to criticize the government. The same supporters backed Roque when he threatened to throw hollow blocks at President Rodrigo Duterte's critics. Roque says, quote, "Citizens should fight for their fellow citizens' right to say a contrary opinion." Roque adds politicians must recognize the role of free expression in strengthening democracies. In just 1 week, Roque went from making the threat against critical media to taking it back after a backlash from netizens and then earning the ire of Duterte online defenders. The Supreme Court junks alleged pork barrel scam mastermind Janet Lim Napoles' bail appeal in the plunder case concerning former Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile. The SC says the Sandigan Bayan had not gravely abused his discretion in denying Napoles' petition for bail. To gain temporary freedom, Napoles has to be granted bail in all three pork barrel scam plunder cases, those with former Senators Bong Revilla, Jinggoy Estrada, and Enrile. The Sandigan Bayan's 3rd Division earlier said the presumption of guilt was strong against Napoles in the plunder charges. Senator Antonio Trillanes says he will file a libel case against Thinking Pinoy blogger RJ Nieto for allegedly peddling fake news that he is a drug lord. Trillanes says the complaint will be on Nieto's post about a column saying United States President Donald Trump allegedly tagged the senator as a little narco. Last week, a couple of columnists came out with a story about Trump supposedly calling Trillanes a little narco who met with U.S. Senator Marco Rubio. The first was written by Filipino Star Ngayon columnist Al Pedroche. Philippine Star columnist Mary Ann Reyes wrote a column citing the same information. Pedroche has apologized to the senator and Trillanes accepted his apology. Trillanes says he will still pursue a libel case against Nieto even if the pro-Duterte blogger makes an apology. Malacanang says it is counting on China to stay true to its word it would not reclaim land in the Scarborough Shoal after reports Beijing launched a massive dredging ship nicknamed the Island Maker. Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzano on Monday said the Philippine government is monitoring the dredger. Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque says, quote, "We need to rely on good faith because otherwise there will be no predictability in international relations." The 140-meter-long ship named Chan Kun Hao is said to be the biggest dredger vessel in Asia, capable of building artificial islands. International security observers are worried it could be deployed to the South China Sea, particularly to reclaim Scarborough Shoal.